Hola, ¿qué tal, amigos? Estamos aquí en Brick by Brick con Serie One. We just saw you guys doing sound check. You sound great. What does the San Diego people is gonna hear from you today?
We've just been performing all the new material that's gonna be on our next record called Black Level 6. So unfortunately, a lot of the people that have been coming out to see the shows that have remembered the band over the last 20 something years, they're very confused as to why we're not playing any of the old material. But we've been told by management to basically just focus on this, get these songs out there, get them tight and ready for when we go back out on tour later in the year, where we're really ready to go. So a bunch of material that nobody's ever heard before.
You just released a lyric video called Save Us. Can you tell more about this video?
Does anybody want to take anything else? See anything?
I think that's more about coronavirus, yep.
So it's funny that the lyric video came out and it's called Save Us, and we're having this big thing, this pandemic in around the world, you know, but that's not why we released it. It just happened to be just weird timing, I guess. Yeah, no, but it's a cool song. I mean, the reason why we released that song is because we're going to be releasing 5 singles over the next 6 months to basically boost up our new Spotify, to have people go and listen to it and make sure that they know it's out there, because we had our old Spotify taken down. And we just wanted people to be aware of our new Spotify and go listen to the music and get awareness. And then we're going to put the new record out. So all the next 5 singles, including Save Us, aren't on the new record.
Last year, you tour were Static. Can you tell most about this last tour?
Yeah, the last tour was great. I mean, I co-directed the next five music videos for Static X. I did the last 3 music videos for Wayne Static when he was still alive. So the guys were kind enough, and I've known them back from the Sunset Strip days back in the mid-90s. So they were kind enough to bring us out and have us out on tour. And it was for the memorial tour last year for Wayne. And it was just an amazing experience. And it was just huge crowds and sold out shows. And I just, it was a dream come true to be able to pay respect back to Wayne and be a part of that and bring this lineup of the band out there. Jimmy, what did you think of the tour?
Like, you know, playing in front of 500 to 1500 people every night and them not knowing really who we are, but yet still by the end of the night they warmed up to us and jumping all over the place and screaming and yelling. I think I saw people actually singing words to songs that I have no idea how they would have even known them. I didn't even know the words, so how any of the crowd knew it, but they must have picked up on the choruses on some of the songs before we were finished with them. So it was a really amazing experience.
Today you're gonna perform with Static. Can you share a memory with Wayne Static when he's still alive on your touring?
Man, I have a lot of memories with Wayne Static, like crazy a lot of memories. So yeah, I'll give you 2 memories, because you said while touring versus one on tour and one off tour. Okay, so the last time I actually saw Wayne before he passed, we were actually on his last show ever in America. We were on that show. I saw Wayne and I stuck around after our set. I had a music video the next day, but I stuck around until he got there, and we actually got to see each other that night before he went on stage. And so we talked a little bit. He went up on stage. I watched maybe half the set, and then I left. And that was the last time I saw him in person before he passed. So that's the last time I saw Wayne. That's the last time we had a show together, an actual Wayne Static. But I think one of my most fond memories of Wayne was probably 1 year during July 4th. He invited me over to his house, when the house that he had out in the desert. And it was me and my girlfriend at the time, him and Tara. And we went, we barbecued, and we listened to the new record, Pig Hammer, before anybody ever heard it before. We put lawn chairs out in his backyard. We watched the fireworks. We just sat there, talked about music, talked about life. You know, it was one of the times that he really opened up to me about how he was really happy with what he had accomplished in his life and what he achieved, and he just really felt completed. And you know, that will always stick with me, because you know, it was only a couple years later after that he passed away. So that always sticks with me, and it kind of gives me a lot of comfort that I know for a fact that he really did what he wanted to do in his life. So that was one of the special ones. And earlier in the night, we were actually jumping on his trampoline that he had in his back. Well, actually, Wayne and I weren't. We were watching our girlfriends jump on the trampoline. And I turned to him and said, hey, this is living, ain't it?
Having fun.
Yeah.
What is next for the band this year?
We're releasing what? Four or five singles. Any music videos? Yeah, we got a music video coming out.
Three
of them. Yeah, and then the rest is kind of up in the air because of the coronavirus.
Yeah.
So we're hoping that song inspires everyone, Save Us, and then we'll be okay.
Save Us and Stay Safe.
about this crisis in the world, about the coronavirus, it's taking all over some festival. What did you think about this pandemic and alcohol?
Yeah, I mean, we live in California. I don't know how many people are in California, 50 million, 60 million. I don't know what the number is, but only 155 people have actually contracted it. And that's a really small percentage. So I get the precautions and I understand why people are nervous, but I'm just hoping that because of the isolation and the ending of sporting events and concerts, this gets wrapped up in the next month or so. And then everybody's okay, and it finally takes its course. But you know what can we do? We didn't even know if tonight was going to happen. You know, because this is sold out. I mean, there's going to be like 1,000 people here. You know, in like an hour, I'm sure there's a line out there. But you know, what can you do other than wash your hands and get sleep and just keep going? I guess. I mean, we're going to be taking a little break after the show, but it's just primarily because we've got a bunch of singles and videos we got to do. But, you know, I'm sure we'll be back out there, you know, in summer, and hopefully by then it's all wrapped up.
Can you send a message to the Mexican fans?
Sure. We want to get down there and play. We'd love to see all of you. First time we actually played this club in like years, like 2 years ago, we had somebody come up from Mexico. And so we know that you're down there, far and few between, but we'd love to come down and bring our style of rock and roll to everybody and just have a great time. So if you're watching this, please tell your local club promoter, have Society One come on down.